Hello everybody, Vasco here from the Angular Academy. We're going to see how to pass input data to a component, and even if you're already aware of this, you might not know how to pass in a string, a simplified way to pass in a string property into a component. Coming right up. So we have here our search box component. Let's add it an input property. In this case, we want to configure what the placeholder text will say instead of search. So for that, we use the square brackets notation to pass in a property into the component. Now, we assign to the text property, we're going to assign a string. Notice the quotes around the string. Without this, this will not work. Now, we are going to declare the property in the component using the @input decorator. We annotate a property name text using the @input decorator, and it's all we need to pass in an input variable to the component. Now, what we want to do is to use the value of the text variable in the component template. In this case, we are going to use the interpolation syntax, so double curly braces. We're going to do a deep dive in the interpolation syntax in a future lesson. Right now, we just use it to output the placeholder value into the template. If we now try this out, we can see that type your search is now displayed in place of the placeholder. Now, for that tip that I mentioned in the beginning of the lesson. This is a very common scenario. We just want to pass in a constant string as an input to the controller. This variable input will not be variable. It will never change. For this, there is a simplified syntax where we can actually remove the square brackets from around the text property, and we can remove the quotes from the string. And like that, we have a simplified way to pass in a string as a constant value for a component input. Next, we are going to see how we can subscribe to a component to receive an output event that it generates. How can we receive data from the component? Stay tuned!